I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes. Hello, and welcome to this DraftSight for Beginners video on customizing a workspace. In this multi-video series, we will develop an architectural drawing. But before we begin, let's take a look at the working environment. When starting with a new CAD package, the number of available commands can be a bit overwhelming. DraftSight comes out of the box with a set of pre-configured workspaces to help us get started. In this video, we will look at how to create and manage workspaces. So, let's get started. We will now look at how to create our own workspace. To manage workspaces, we right-click and select Customize Interface. The UI profiles show all the workspaces currently available. We can use the icons on the right of the dialog to delete or add workspaces. For now, we want a new workspace, so we will click Add to create one and call it Drafting Team. We can add ribbons, menus, toolbars, and elements by expanding the appropriate options in the lower half of the screen. We'll start with Ribbons tab and expand the Explorer to see all the ribbons that are currently available to us. We can then drag and drop the ones that we want from the Explorer to the appropriate UI name. If we make a mistake and prefer a different order, we can simply drag and drop it to the appropriate position. Then continue to add any more ribbons we want available. Next, we want some menus. Using the same process, we will expand the Menus Explorer and drag drop those we want to include. We cannot drag drop ribbons to the menus and vice versa, so we do need to know what we want to add and where we want to take it from. We add elements by double clicking on the appropriate column. Once we have added everything we want, we can click Apply and OK to create the new workspace and try it out. It's easy to miss things, and as we become more proficient, we are likely to want to include more commands. However, we can edit and update our workspace at any time. We forgot to include a quick access toolbar, so we will access the customized interface again by right-clicking and selecting from the contextual menu. In the UI profiles, we will expand the quick access toolbar and select the quick access toolbar from the dropdown. We will then click Apply and OK to realize the changes to the workspace. Through these customization options, we can ensure our team has a familiar working environment with only those tools that are relevant to meet the challenges of their daily tasks. In our next video, we will look at how to create and customize palettes. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for even more great content and click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses.